Hi everyone, I'm Alicia and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, then don't forget to subscribe to my channel and let's get started with today's video. So there are various kind of journal available today. For example, travel journal, dream journal, food journal, artistic journal, fitness journal and so much more. But today we are going to talk about bullet journal. Many people think that bullet journaling is waste of time, but if you put your mind into it, it will actually help you to grow. So basically, bullet journal is a personal journal that helps to schedule your time, organize your months and years, and also helps you to setting goals for your life and so much more. In short, it's a journal to organize your life. Now we have two options here. Option number one, buy a bullet journal. So there are several bullet journals out there in the market. You can go and buy one according to your preference. Or option number two, you can make one for yourself. And today we are going for option number two. Now, if you search how to make your own bullet journal, you will get thousands of results out there. You might get overwhelmed and confused. That's why I am going to simplify everything for you today. Now, coming to the journal, I have divided it into 5 parts. General, yearly, monthly, weekly and daily. Don't get scared, it's super simple. Now, the first thing after getting a journal is to claim that it's yours. You have to introduce yourself. For example, this is how I introduced myself. I'm not very good at drawing, but somehow I manage it. If you are good at it, then you are lucky. Here I have kept everything simple. These are few pictures popping on the screen from where you can get some ideas for your journal. All these pictures are from Pinterest. You can download this app and get some idea for your own journal. Now let's move on to life goals. After introducing yourself, the next thing you can do is to write down all your goals for your life. It can be anything. For example, you want to buy a new house, you want to adopt a puppy, you want to buy a new phone, you want to travel somewhere. It can be anything. Whatever it is, you can write it down or you can doodle it, which means you can draw it. Let's say you want to buy a new house. So open the app Pinterest and search house doodle. Now choose one according to your preference and draw it. Now coming to the next part, that is current me versus future me. This is the best exercise for your own development. So what you have to do is, on current me page, you have to write down your current status, like your personality, your social behavior, your appearance, about your look, the way you dress, about your work status. It can be anything. Similarly, on the future me section, you have to write down whatever you want to be in your future. So this is your present version and this will be your desired future version. Again, you can write it down or you can simply doodle it. Now the general part is over, moving to the yearly part. Next is your monthly log. So here you just have to make a calendar for yourself and then you have to write down all of your important dates. Just mark all of the important dates, your appointment, everything. As you can see, I have kept it simple over here, but if you want to be more artistic, then you can also opt for Pinterest and get some ideas. Now moving on to goals for the year. Here you can write down all of the goals that you want to accomplish this year. Here you can write down your goals for your career, your finance, anything personal, like for physical fitness or for your mental state, anything. It can be anything. Now moving on to vision board. This is a vision board for your goals. Ultimately they are your goals, but in visual form. For example, you want to visit to Paris this year. So what you can do is, you can go to Pinterest, search Paris, and whatever picture is relevant to you, download it, print it out, and just paste it on your vision board section. So yeah, you can make it according to your own preference. Now moving on to budget planning. So if you are a working woman or man, you have to plan out your budget. So basically you have to plan out budget according to your income, how and where you are spending money. This will help you to keep a track of your spending status, and also you can avoid overspending your money. Now coming to saving, if you really want to buy something or travel somewhere or for your emergency fund, you can save money for it. So this page will help you as a reminder to save your money every single month. Next comes the book section. If you really love reading books, then this page is for you. So here you keep a track of the books that you have read, and sidewise you can also review that book if you want. But if you don't like reading that much, then you can obviously skip this page. Now this page is very fun. So in this page you have to list down the things that you want to do before the year ends. So it's kind of a bucket list, but it's fun to make. Now let's come to memories. So here you can either paste a picture of your memory, best memory for the month, or you can write down your best memories for the month, for each and every month from January to December. Now moving on to things you are grateful for every single month. For example, let's say in January, I'm grateful for spending more time with my family. Like this, you can write what you are grateful for every single month. Now let's move on to the monthly section. So here you have to plan out things for each and every month. For example, for the month of January, you have to write down the goals for the month. You can also include a habit tracker to keep a track of your habit, or if you have decided to include a new positive habit in your life, just write it down in the habit section, and when you complete that task, just tick it off. Now let's move on to the weekly section. So here you have to plan out things for each and every week, not in details, but briefly you have to plan out your week. Now coming to the daily section, this is your to-do list section where you have to plan out things in a more specific way. You have to plan things in more detail. So these are the things that you can include in your journal. So if this video was helpful for you, then don't forget to like this video. Also subscribe to my channel because it's completely free. And what else? I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.